वेलकम टू सिंपली लॉजिकल, दिस इज वेंकटेश। हंड्रेड प्रिजनर्स इन जेल आर स्टैंडिंग इन ए क्यू फेसिंग इन वन डायरेक्शन। ईच प्रिजनर इज वेयरिंग ए हैट ऑफ कलर ईदर ब्लू और रेड। ए प्रिजनर कैन सी हैट्स ऑफ ऑल प्रिजनर्स इन फ्रंट ऑफ हिम इन द क्यू बट कैनॉट सी हिज हैट एंड हैट्स ऑफ प्रिजनर्स स्टैंडिंग बिहाइंड हिम। द जेलर इज गोइंग टू आस्क color of each prisoner's hat starting from the last prisoner in the queue. If a prisoner tells the correct color, then he is saved, otherwise executed. How many prisoners can be saved at most if they are allowed to discuss a strategy before the jailer starts asking colors of their hats? So I will repeat the puzzle. 100 prisoners in jail are standing in a queue facing in one direction. Each prisoner is wearing a hat of color either blue or red. A prisoner can see hats of all prisoners in front of him in the queue but cannot see his hat and hats of prisoners standing behind him. The jailer is going to ask color of each prisoner's hat starting from the last prisoner in queue. If a prisoner tells the correct color, then he is saved, otherwise executed. How many prisoners can be saved at most if they are allowed to discuss a strategy before the jailer starts asking colors of their hats? Feel free to pause the video and try yourself before checking the solution. Let's everyone know your answer in the comment section. Let me explain the solution now. This puzzle appears in a book called Are You Smart Enough to Work at Google? Quite incredibly, in February 2016, it seems to have been solved by Google's own artificial intelligence program. The solution to this puzzle is: at most, 99 prisoners can be saved and the 100th prisoner has 50-50 chances of being executed. So how? So let me explain the solution in step by step. The person at the back, let's call him person number 100, will agree that if he sees an odd number of red hats, he calls out red. If he sees an even number of red hats, he calls out blue. Obviously, any similar scheme would work, but we will use this particular one. Unfortunately, this means he has a 50% chance of survival, but it guarantees everyone else. This is because he himself, that is 100th person, himself not aware of the color of the hat he is wearing, hence his survival chances is 50%. So the idea is that every prisoner counts number of red hats in front of him. Consider an example of just 5 people. Here, person 1 follows the only rule: if the first person sees an odd number of red hats, he calls out red. If he sees an even number of red hats, he calls out blue. Here he calls out blue because he sees an even number of red hats and dies. So person 2 knows that including himself, there are an even number of red hats. He looks forward and can also see an even number of red hats. This means he is wearing a blue hat. Had he been wearing a red hat, then the person behind him would have seen 3, an odd number, which he knows not to be the case. Person 3 knows that to start there were an even number of red hats. He knows that none of them have gone, that is to say nobody other than possibly the first person has declared themselves to be wearing a red hat. So including himself, there are an even number of red hats. He looks forward and can see one red hat, an odd number. That this has changed between him and the people in front of him means he is wearing a red hat. So next, person 4 knows that to start there were an even number of red hats. He knows one has gone, so including himself, there is an odd number of red hats. He looks forward and counts 0, an even number of red hats. That this has changed between including and excluding him means he is wearing a red hat. Person 5 knows that to start, there were an even number of red hats. He knows that 2 have gone, so including himself, there is an even number of red hats. He looks forward and counts 0, an even number of red hats. That this has not changed between including and excluding him means he is wearing a blue hat. So generally, someone knows whether the group of n minus 1 people started with an odd or an even number of red hats. And they know the number of red hats that have gone before them. If the number of red hats that have gone before them is even, then the number of red hats, including them and those forward of them, will be as indicated by the first person. If it is odd, it will be opposite. Knowing the odd or even nature of the number of red hats, including them and the group in front of them, they can observe the group in front of them, and if they are not the same, it must be changed by the hat they are wearing. So all but the first person survives, and he would have survived had he been wearing a blue hat. This gives us an expected survival rate of 99.5% for 100 people. We can now try a more formulated response to a larger group of 100 people. Let's analyze the responses. If 100 person said red, there must have been odd number of red hats in front of him. If 99th prisoner sees odd number of red hats in front of him, then his color is blue. If the 99th prisoner sees even number of red hats in front of him, then his color is red. If 100th prisoner said blue, there must have been even number of red hats in front of him. If 99th prisoner sees odd number of red hats in front of him, then his color is red. If 99th prisoner sees even number of red hats in front of him, then his color is blue. The 98th prisoner decides his answer on the basis of answer of 99th prisoner's answer and uses the same logic. Similarly, other prisoners from 97 to 1 are saved. So all other prisoners follows the same approach what 99th prisoner followed. So that's all about the logic. Hope you understood the approach required to solve this kind of puzzle. So here is a question for you. So how do you approach this problem if there were three colors of hats or more? Let's everyone know your answer in the comment section. Please subscribe for free to get the newest videos watching. Thanks for watching and thank you for your support. Let's meet in the next video.